Hello everyone, I am Dr. Deepti Kulkarni and today we are going to see some things about laser. Laser stands for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation, and that is obtained in atoms. For atomic systems, the energy of atom can be changed by three mechanisms or three processes we can say. First one is absorption. Second one is the spontaneous emission, and third one is the stimulated emission. So let's see how absorption takes place. Consider an atomic system with two energy levels E1 and E2. When a photon of energy h nu equal to E2 minus E1 is incident on this atomic system, then energy of the photon is absorbed by the atom at ground state, and it gets excited to the energy level E2. This process is called as a absorption. Then let's see what is spontaneous emission. When the atom excited to the energy level E2, it will remain there for 10 raised to minus 8 seconds. After completion of this time period, which is called as a lifetime of atom in excited state, after completion of this time, atom spontaneously decays to its original energy level with the emission of a photon having energy E2 minus E1. This emission of photon is called as a spontaneous emission. Third process that changes the energy of atom is stimulated emission. Consider atom is in excited state. Before completion of lifetime, if another photon of matching energy E2 minus E1 is incident on this atomic system, then this photon forces atom, excited atom, to decay with the emission of two photons. These two photons are having energy E2 minus E1 and they are in the same phase. But in order to get the continuous laser emission, population inversion must take place. Now, what is population inversion? It is nothing but the state where the number of atoms in excited state are more than the number of atoms in ground state. So that when a photon of matching energy is incident on this system, these atoms decay and we get the continuous laser emission. In order to get this population inversion, there is a need to generate metastable state. This metastable state is an intermediate energy level where the lifetime of atoms is 10 raised to minus 3 seconds. So we can achieve the population inversion. And the atoms can be excited to the higher energy level by a pumping method. Now let's see the first laser, that is ruby laser. Ruby is nothing but the crystal of aluminium oxide doped with chromium oxide by 0.05%. These chromium ions are active ions. That means laser action is possible for chromium ions itself. The atoms, chromium atoms, can be excited by a flash tube. So when a flash tube incident light on this ruby crystal, chromium atom gets excited by absorbing energy in 4000 to 6000 angstrom. So blue and green region is absorbed by the ruby crystal, or we can say chromium ions. So these ions will remain in the excited state for 10 raised to minus 8 seconds. Then they decay to the metastable state. Here, the energy is transferred through the thermal vibrations. So, when they decay to the metastable state, they will remain there for 10 raised to minus 3 seconds, and population inversion is achieved in the metastable state. Initially, when population inversion is not there, some of the chromium ions decays to the ground state after completion of lifetime from metastable state, and then they emit the radiations of wavelength. Then they emit the radiations of wavelength 4900 angstrom. So these protons further incident on the ions in metastable state, and these ions from metastable state decays by the stimulated emission, and hence laser photons are emitted. So these laser photons moves back and forth in the resonant cavity, and then a strong laser beam emitted through this ruby crystal. So here, through one atom, we can get two laser photons, and hence we can say the amplification of light takes place by the stimulated emission. All the photons emitted, they are of same wavelength and they propagate in the same direction. This is the energy level diagram. When the light is incident, white light is incident, it absorbs blue and green component. It excites to the energy level, higher energy level, say E3 and E4. Then they decays to the metastable state by non-radiative transition. In metastable state, the population inversion takes place, and then a chance photon having wavelength 6943 angstrom incident on it, then it triggers the stimulated emission. So once it started, it continues and we get a laser photon. So by now you have seen how ruby laser works. Can you identify the characteristics of laser photons emitted? You can pause the video for a minute and write answer. So I hope by now you have written your answer. So let's see what are the characteristics of laser. As I said, the light photons emitted by the stimulated emission, they are having same wavelength, that means they are monochromatic, and hence they are having same frequency. They are in phase with each other, they are having same phase, and they are unidirectional. So as they are having same phase, unidirectional, they are coherent, and they are plain polarized radiation. So you can see the coherence, they are same in phase, whereas these are incoherent photons. So the characteristics of laser are, they are coherent, plane polarized, unidirectional and monochromatic in nature. And the typical applications of laser is for reading and writing of CDs. They are used in LIDAR, that is laser radar. It is used to measure the distance between Earth and Moon. It is used for drilling, cutting, welding, in car industries, PCBs, electronics. It is used for welding and soldering also. It is used for printing, where laser is used for scanning the material. It is used in medical applications widely, for bloodless cancer surgery, in laser angioplasty, dermatology, ophthalmology, photometry and cell cytometry, in dentistry for root canal purpose. So there are wide applications of laser because they are unidirectional, and we can focus them over a few micrometer diameter spot. Thank you so much.